As we so painfully know, without fail, severe weather across our country delivers punishing blows on a regular basis. From dangerous winter storms to even high-risk floods, we get it all, so to speak.
I'd be surprised if this guy makes it the mile and a half that he's got to go. And as you can see right there, he didn't make it very far.
Numerous small tornadoes and occasional large, life-threatening major tornadoes.
There's so many power lines around here, Val. I want you to be careful.
With huge hail and damaging winds, they all occur way too often. Tropical disturbances ravage the coastal areas, and on occasion, believe it or not, a tropical event will make its way to Oklahoma. The injuries, deaths, and damages are always with us, it seems. Is mitigation possible? Can we reduce the number of fatalities and injuries? Well, based on my lifetime in weather, dealing with large, deadly tornadoes and other horrific events, I say yes. I believe we can improve on the results. However, even though forecasts, watches, and warnings have improved dramatically over the years, we need your help in leading everyone to become weather aware. It's simple, become weather aware. If a single person, a neighborhood, an organization, a business entity, or an entire community stays weather aware, knows all the safety precautions, and are willing to take action, then we will see less pain and suffering in the future. Since thunderstorms are the source and risk of most warm season severe events in the Great Plains, we will focus mainly on those necessary but sometimes devastating creations. The processes taking place in our atmosphere that produce the weather we experience each day are extremely complex. Just imagine evaluating the mingling of physics and chemistry and mathematics, oceanography, even the impact of high-energy particles from beyond our solar system. Pretty amazing. Let's take a look at this. This is a computer model based on the Piedmont F5 tornado, an extreme tornado. Now, is this wild or not that you can take mathematics and physics, all of this, and create a model that comes very close to what it actually looked like that day? Once again, that's a Piedmont, Oklahoma EF5. The model produces a system that very closely resembles the actual supercell. Now, I have to tell you, complex seems too weak of a word to describe what we see here. But there is good news. Even though the study of atmospheric processes is complicated, intricate, and multifaceted, the ongoings in our atmosphere can be explained in simple terms that most anyone can grasp. We can do meteorology without the math if we have to. And that's how we'll go through this course. When you finish, you will have practical knowledge of severe weather, how it comes about, why it goes away. You will have the basic of pre-storm and during the storm and after the storm. You'll have all those particular items you can fit together to help you know what's going on. You will know how to stay weather aware. If you fear storms, my goal is to help you lessen that fear so you'll be able to safely take care of yourself and your family whenever severe weather comes along. So often we fear what we don't understand. If you're just curious about weather, you too will benefit, as this is a fascinating world. If you're really into weather, you may learn some things you don't know. If you represent yourself, a neighborhood watch group, or a small organization, or a large corporation, there is value for you too. It doesn't make any difference whether you're a computer programmer, housewife, working mother, teacher, truck driver, first responder, or leader of the church choir. You will find use in this course. It will be invaluable.